Okay, this first one we have, a y-intercept of 2, a slope of 4/3, there's not enough room to go that way, so I'll just come back this direction. Come down 4 and to the left 3. We've got a y-intercept of negative 1 and a slope of negative 1 half. That means we're going to go back 2 and up 1. Hopefully I've drawn my line pretty well. Where does it look like they cross?
Negative 6.
Negative 6 and 2. Did anybody have time to check that solution?
I got negative 9/4.
I got
negative 5/45. Did you graph it right? Did they have the y-intercept and the slope right?
Yeah.
I just drew a bad graph.
Yeah, a hand-drawn graph, hand-drawn axes, hand-drawn like spacing between the tick marks, everything hand-drawn, you can start to see why graphing might be great. Like, if I want to use graphing as a way to find the solutions, I have to assume the solution is kind of nice, like whole numbers, and I have to draw it really well. You have like
these are fun.
They're little sticky notes with graphs on them. These are for back in the day, like before computers were really, really useful. You'd actually stick those on your test and then go make copies. You're less amazed by that than I am. 2003. I mean. It was 4 years before the first iPhone came out. It was probably close to when you were born.
Year after.
2001. Yeah, those pads are almost as old as some of you. So, anyway, to get a good looking graph, you either have to have those sticky notes or a ruler and that's why we're not going to do a lot of these, just a few. But we can test it, just to make sure. So y, well, actually, y should be what?
2
should equal 4/3 times negative 6 plus 10. Let's see, 2 equals negative 2. 4 times negative 2, negative 8 plus 10. That's 2, okay? And the other one, 2 should equal negative 1/2 times negative 6 times 1, negative 3, negative 1 times negative 3 is 3, minus 1, 3 minus 1 is 2. Does work. So I'll put the homework here in a minute, and when I do, it's going to be a bunch of graphing. But I just want to tease you a little bit about what it's going to look like in the future. Okay? You can see how graphing is not so fantastic. But it was nice for a while. Talking about like we're not even doing it anymore, that you do have homework on graphing. But we're going to kiss it goodbye soon because it's just not a great long-term solution. We need something a little more elegant, a little more exact. All right? So let me just put another system of equations up there, 2x plus y okay. equals 3. I just want to give you something for your brain to mull over this entire weekend, okay? We're looking for a solution to the system, agreed?
Yes.
Okay, of course, because I'm making you do it, so that's what we're doing. All right, and the solution's gonna look like this, right?
Yes.
An x and a y, okay? What about that x and y?
We have to ask the solution to the equations.
To both of the equations, right? So this x needs to what? It needs to be replaced. It needs to replace this x, not only this x, but also this x. Like both of those x's
Wait,
need to be the same.
You just look at it and it's. You subtract 2x from each side.
You can kind of figure out the solution. It's not that hard to find out. And if you figure out what it is, that's not that important. What I want to do is help you find a way to find solutions. Okay, so don't get too hung up on finding it yet. I want to help you understand why it is we can do what we are going to do on Monday. Okay, so that X, right, it's black. Those two X's are black, representing that they're the same X. Okay? Let's put red on this guy here, or red Y. Okay, meaning just color coding this. This should be the same as that Y. This should be the same as that Y. Agreed so far?
Yeah.
Are you going to try and tell me the solution? I don't want to know the solution. I don't care what the solution is. I want you to pay attention here. Okay? So put another way, I might tell you, all right, X is, right, like that black X there is this number, right? And whatever number I write here needs to go there and there, agreed?
Yeah.
Okay, now, I'm just going to get you to agree to something here. Then I can tell you Y is this number, right? Now this is the thing that I want you to agree to, this is the thing that you're going to mull over. This is the thing that you're just gonna like feel fine about, so that when I write this thing down on Monday, it's gonna be no big surprise. Whatever I write here, whatever, anything. If I write 5, right, then 5 should go there and there, right? If I write 12, then 12, I should be able to plug 12 in there and in there. Agreed? That's all I want you to do. I just want to agree to that whatever on Monday that I write here, whatever it is, that can be plugged in there. 3-4 can be plugged in there, right? Okay, so cliffhanger, you might be able to figure out the solution. The solution is not a very big number. It's not too hard to just kind of figure out, all right? What we're going to come up with is a way to solve any system, okay? And again, whatever, and right here, I should be able to plug it in right there, okay? So the conclusion to that on Monday.